other world, you step down into darkness. Open my eyes, let me see beauty that made this heart adore you. Hope of a life spent with you. So here I am to worship. Here I am to bow down. Here I am to say that you're my God. You're altogether lovely, altogether worthy, altogether wonderful to me. King of all days, oh, so highly exalted, glorious in heaven above. Humbly you came to the earth you created, all for love's sake became poor. So here I am to worship, here I am to bow down, here I am to say that you're my God. You're altogether lovely, altogether worthy, altogether wonderful to me.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Thank you.
keep in honor of the risen Lord, and that what we live in remembrance we may always hold to in what we do. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who is reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Philip went down to the city of Samaria and proclaimed the Christ to them. With one accord, the crowds paid attention to what was said by Philip when they heard it and saw the signs he was doing. For unclean spirits, crying out in a loud voice, came out of many possessed people, and many paralyzed or crippled people were cured. There was great joy in that city. Now, when the apostles in Jerusalem heard that Samaria had accepted the word of God, they sent them Peter and John, who went down and prayed for them, that they might receive the Holy Spirit, for it had not yet fallen upon any of them. They had only been baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. Then they laid hands on them, and they received the Holy Spirit. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
That be the will of God, than for doing evil. For For Christ also suffered for sins once, the righteous for the sake of the unrighteous, that he might lead you to God. Put to death in the flesh, he was brought to life in the spirit. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
The word reader is advocate. can, in fact, be accurately translated in many other ways. One version says, I will give you another comforter. Still another, I will give you another counselor. And a third version reads, I will give you another friend. Jesus is describing the Holy Spirit in your life and mine. The original Greek word paraclete means, literally, one who is called alongside to help. So, what is the task of this Holy Spirit in your life and in mine? The Spirit is alongside to help. I think a story makes this a little clearer. You know, when I was gathering our thoughts together the other day, I didn't even know what day it was, but it was Tuesday, I had to think. Nowadays, it's hard to know what day of the week it is. But what I did know on Tuesday, May 12th, was that it was International Nurses Day. And I think this year really highlights, doesn't it, to all of us, we've always been appreciative of nurses and the compassionate work they do. But in the times we're living through currently, I think they've been highlighted as such important, courageous, frontline workers. I have a few friends that are nurses, and I hear some of their stories. So they're really wearing so many hats at the same time, being in positions they never would have found themselves in, with a patient typically isolated in a room in the hospital. And so I give a big shout out to nurses today. And here's a little story. A man was about to undergo open heart surgery. The day before the surgery, a nurse visited him, and she took hold of his hand and told him to hold her hand so he could feel it. Tomorrow, she said, tomorrow you will be disconnected from your heart. Machines will be keeping you alive. When finally you are reconnected, you will wake up in a recovery room. You will stay there, absolutely alone, unable to move or speak or even to open your eyes. But you will be perfectly conscious. I will be with you and hold your hand, just like I'm doing now. You may feel absolutely hopeless, but when you feel my hand, you know I will not leave you. That's kind of the idea. It's a life-changing experience to know someone is alongside us when we need a helping hand. Jesus says the same Spirit who stood with him through the cross to the resurrection is available to all of his disciples in every age. That Spirit is at once advocate, comforter, counselor, and friend. We are a people never alone, never bereft. That's what Jesus means by I will not leave you orphans. So, if you feel alone these days, know that the Spirit of Jesus is within you, alongside you, and with you. God does not leave us alone. He never will. And in the power of that same Spirit, Jesus sends comforter, to be advocate. To those who need us. For the power and loving presence of Jesus risen and the Spirit given, we give thanks at the altar to the Lord our God. And together we profess our faith as we pray. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men, for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Jesus never leaves us alone. He has made us his children by our baptism and will not leave us orphans. The gift of the Holy Spirit is our ever-present hope as we walk this journey of faith. Grateful for that gift, we lift our prayers to Christ, who is faithful and attentive as we pray.
For the Church, that she would be agile in responding to the needs of the faithful in this unprecedented time, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For every Catholic feeling longing, sadness, and hopelessness in the face of being separated from the sacraments, may God's holy word be a reminder that Christ never leaves us. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the faithful who are awaiting the day of their own confirmation, may God grant them his steady virtues of faith, hope, and love in their abiding. May God send down on them a unique outpouring of the Holy Spirit in their wait. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our own community, that we might be patient and attentive to the voices of experts in the medical profession regarding the necessarily careful steps to ensuring the health and safety of all. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us, all of those who have died as a result of COVID-19, and in a particular way at this Mass for the more than 5,100 people who have lost their lives in Massachusetts alone, may they see the fulfillment of Christ's promise of eternal life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Loving God, we know you are the promise maker and the promise keeper. We thank you for the gift of the Holy Spirit, particularly in a time when our isolation can make even you feel distant. Help us know your presence with us by your grace. We make our prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
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 Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May our prayers rise up to you, O Lord, together with the sacrificial offerings, so that, purified by your graciousness, we may be conformed to the mysteries of your mighty love. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation. At all times to proclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to bow to you yet more gloriously. When Christ our Passover has been sacrificed, by the oblation of his body, he brought the sacrifices of all to fulfillment in the reality of the cross, and by commending himself to you for our salvation, showed himself the priest, the altar, and the lamb of sacrifice. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, giving thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Thank you.
your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven. And as we look forward to the second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint John the Evangelist, with Saint Paul, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant, Francis our Pope, Sean our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There, we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in thy unity of all,
thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Well, I really miss seeing all of you together. together in front of me. Please know you're continually in my prayers. Stay healthy and well, and I really can't wait for the day in which we see each other in person again. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace. Glorifying the Lord by your life.